all of the regions of the UK are stronger and better off in Europe, and that's because we get access to a huge amount of EU funding, around £8 billion between 2014 and 2020 will go on Britain's poorer regions, helping to create jobs, helping support businesses, helping to give people the skills and training that they need. That is money on top of what the UK government spends, and it allows people to find jobs and to get out of unemployment. There are particular areas which do well and get the most funding from the EU in this area, and they include Wales, where there have been problems with the Tata Steel Works, for example. That helps people to get back into work and to get more skills and get back on and get their livelihood up and running. Also in the southwest, areas like Cornwall, where people want training and skilling up and getting back into the workplace too, they have received a huge amount of funding. And in Wales, it's around £1.9 billion in that 2014 to 2020. And in the southwest, it's over £700 million. And all of this funding would be at risk were we to leave the EU. We would no longer have access to that pot of money. And Leave campaigns may say that the UK government would just replicate that. They'd find that money from somewhere. But actually, they couldn't, because we would still have to pay into the EU budget, depending on what trade deal we got. So that money would no longer be available. And as well as that regional funding, there are also specific projects all around the UK which benefit from EU money. That includes in our universities, where they're working on crucial projects for cancer research, drugs, and all kinds of crucial medical breakthroughs, where there is ongoing funding, whether it's for cancer or for AIDS or dementia research and all these things. Those projects are reliant on EU funding, and they're also reliant on cooperation between European countries, where the academics, the best in Europe, all come together and work together, and that is through European cooperation. A really important point about the way EU money is spent is that it is according to need. It is according to where people have pitched for projects and where there is a real need and there are poorer areas. So that money goes directly to where it's needed. And it's also checked by UK agencies. It isn't just spent directly. It doesn't come straight from EU institutions. It is all channeled through the local areas. So it filters down and it gets to where it needs to go. So actually, we are far stronger. All of our regions are far stronger, whether it's Wales, Scotland, or Northern Ireland, where Northern Ireland benefits from the EU peace funding, which helps to ensure stability and economic progress in Northern Ireland, to make sure that that peace is kept and that there is a well-functioning and a well-resourced society, and that people have everything that they need. And that really is at the heart of the EU. It is working together, it is cooperating, and it is providing resources for things and people that need it most.